And welcome everybody here to the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. We are here to help out Save the Children. They help out refugee children all around the world. And we're here to give those guys some extra acknowledgements. And hopefully also as many donations as possible to just get up a nice donation pool to give them. Our first goal is 2,000 euros. And at the end of the tournament, we hope to have breached that by far. But let's start with that. Go from there, as we've already 560 euros in the prize pool, so, or in prize pool, in the donation pool for now, of which 75% goes to Save Children, 25% will be used to give the winning team something for their time here, everybody else. Well, they get nothing, so it's essentially, it's all about winning. It's a double elimination style tournament. We have invited 8 teams here. The 8 teams are, as you can see for today, is No Logic Gaming, as well as Sapphire TV. On top of that, we have Enzo. We have Hehe United. We have Team Mid English as well. 5 seconds remaining. So yeah, we have already we're pretty stacked already in that sense. From just hearing those teams, of course, we also have London Conspiracy, who decided to were able to get them in as well fairly like 2 days ago or yesterday even. So we're really happy about having those guys here as well. Apart from that, we of course also have Danish Bears and Eternal Envy's Disciples. So. We have a pretty stacked tournament, I would say, here. As, well, with all of that done, we've had a bit of an introduction now. I'm at Sander underscore Dota. Make sure to follow me on my Twitter. We're here on the Swiss DC channel. We have organized as a Swiss Dota community as well this tournament. Today, there are no German casters. It will just be me here on the English channel. I won't have a co-caster either, so... Let's see how everything goes for now, and we see the first picks coming out here from No Logic Gaming as well as Sapphire TV. So No Logic Gaming, they went up for the Doom and TA first. So they have a target who has low armor, and they pick up something themselves that actually lowers armor on the enemy side with a TA, also a strong mid laner. Can hold his own against, most of the enemies, essentially. Actually, Sapphire TV, they ban out the Meepo here. Let's say just this. This is against Excalibur. That's all there is to it. He is a really strong Meepo player. Just they didn't want to give it to him. Meepo is pretty strong against Doom. You can just take out the Meepo that's focused and go from there. TA is, well, at the same time that she can blow up a Meepo, or at least for Sapphire TV, you know. 10 seconds. Yeah, Slaughter Desert. They're not so strong as against Meepo. Never mind. I was looking at the wrong side. What's wrong with me? A bit giddy. But okay, yeah. Slaughter, Dazzle, pretty basic combination, have a lot of synergy, just minus armor as well, giving your own team more armor. Dazzle with the Shadow Grave, just helping out the Slaughter once when he wants to go really, really aggressive and just go and get those kills. As Sephiroth TV also been out the leash to get it with the Winter Weapon in the second phase, it does straight up open up the energy pick, the Wind Ranger. As in, you don't have anything against that now anymore. Energy ban out Shadow Fiend, Darkseer. Dusk and Undying, not really a whole lot to say about, just strong heroes that you don't want to deal with.
Seconds remaining.
Yeah, having that said,
5 seconds remaining.
Venomancer are now also here for Sephira, so it's such an annoying hero to play against. You can put him in mid as well, which seems for now to be the pickup, as well as pick up Wraith King here, strong position, one hero. Could still be put in a support role as well if they maybe pick up an anti-mage for one of their lanes. NLG is now settled just for Bane. Strong lane support. So yeah, it can do a lot, you know, of course goes through magical immunity as well, which makes the BKB carriers think twice about it. So far at the moment, NLG, all of their heroes go through BKB pretty much. TA, all about physical, Doom has Doom that always goes through it. Wind Ranger, Focus Fire goes through it, as well as the Bane's Fiend script, so. Getting a BKB this game might not prove too useful for the status of Hero TV at the same time. For NLG, they could just pretty much pick it up here as they block out all of the damage done by the Venomancer. Might even look for an early pipe as well. You just neglect most of this damage coming out.
Ten 10 seconds remaining.
So yeah. So Razor's not gonna be banned up by energy. They don't wanna give Sephir to be too easy of the lanes. As well, just because actually it's against the TA, so you don't really wanna put it up there. Just makes life for Excalibur harder and harder. Having this constant damage drain coming up in you as well, forcing you to go boots first on the TA is not something you really want to do. Because if Razor has boots before you, that lane is pretty much just lost instantly. So just banning it out is a logical thing.
10 seconds remaining.
Thank you, I want to be that Yoshi. Yeah, we'll be there someday. So, less picks are now coming in, Sephir to be there, missing a mid laner. Unless the Venomancer is going to go there, then they miss most likely another support. They can go a lot of ways with their lineup right now, but I would say that they either pick up a mid or support now. Though most of the mid lanes have been taken out, this Queen of Pain is still there. Not the best against TA, as you're able to just neglect most of the damage given with Refraction and even just dodge it as long as there's no sentry. So they might think about that one twice. There are not a whole lot of strong possibilities here. I would say Venomancer against TA is just okay for the Venomancer, as he will just completely destroy the TA. Refraction charges have absolutely no use against a Venomancer who just puts out all this constant damage with the poison. So it's not really a favorable lane for the TA, and the Venomancer should be able to win it and even take out an early tower as well. So, 15 seconds left, they have their time, so let's see what they're gonna pick up now. Maybe themselves are still a bit thinking about how we're gonna run this, where we're gonna put everybody, and
5 seconds remaining.
How will we do it?
Pudge.
And okay, they go for a pudge. I was not expecting this one from Sephir TV. So this is gonna be a mid pudge, I guess. Yeah, okay, it's okay, as in, you know, Roth is able to take away the Refraction charges. At the same time, you're running a melee against a TA, which means that TA has a good time. The slow is a little bit hard to deal with, but once you get boots, you should be okay.
Remaining.
I'm interested to see how this goes. It can kind of go like two ways. Purge can be completely arrested out of the lane, or the Purge can arrest the TA completely out of the lane. So, at least going invis with TA now has no use anymore. She's just going to stand on top of you and rot. Can even hook you as well. NLG, the answer back with the last support here, the Agent Appreciation. So that means Push has his rod on, he's just gonna lose so much HP. As well as denying himself is not really an option anymore. So with all of that done, we have the lineups completed here for both sides. So let's see how it all goes.
Prepare for battle.
For the side here on NLG in the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament, we have Excalibur on his TA, Spartan on his Agent Appreciation. We have 578 with Milan on the main. We have Chihaya playing the Wind Ranger, and that leaves, of course, Sabeni Umichika. Okay. His name didn't get through either here, playing the Doom. A moment, he's gonna be playing the Dazzle here on the Radiant side, Sephira TV, together with Take Dragon. Okay, we'll just ignore him for them. We'll get a fix next game. Quarpa is gonna be playing the Pudge. He's actually a support player so far, I know. So we might just see the roaming support Pudge this game. We have Fuhu playing the Venomance here.
30 seconds to battle.
And Luft is gonna be playing the Slaughter. We have stalemate here, they see each other, and we're gonna see how it goes. There is a hook, so an easy hook there. Spartan giving out the shout out to Charity. The Charity is, of course, Save the Children. Make sure to go there, check out their website, give them some love. But here, donate there, or go to our stream tip. Go to just streamtip.com/t/SwissDC_EN. As now we're gonna have an engagement here. Rayfire Blast comes out in the bay. We're gonna follow them. Oh, they're rotting him up really, really hard. Quippy's taking a lot of damage, though, and with the Bracep, Milan is able to survive a bit longer, but Luft will in the end take the kill. Spartan is still putting out the damage here. They haven't actually been able to get a kill. Rayfire Blast comes out, and they're going to just make it a double kill here for Sephira TV.
My venom
At the same time, at least Doom has been able to pick up the rune without any contest. Yeah, Milan not too happy about this one. And yeah, Webpage just denying himself, spend his gold, goes back to base with a rot. Needs to get his level 2 before he can really start rotating out. Okay, we are gonna have this mid lane Venomancer as I expected. Doesn't have any points in the board game just yet or in the ward, so Excalibur for now should be okay. Apart from when he misses, he gets an uphill miss. Doom, yeah, he's not gonna be too happy with this spot here. It's not the easiest of lanes to be against. He can just constantly walk up against you and just rot you out of the lane. They just have enough mana for one Brave 5 less, so if they go for it, they really need to go for it. Quipe really needs to get level 2 before they can do that, though. Turn top, yeah, they see Chain Touch coming out and straight up go walk back. They don't really want to fight into this. This 15 magical damage is just too much in the beginning. Oh, and Spartan, he is found. Shadow Wave is gonna hit and they're gonna kill him off. Now Poison does come out on TI. He needs to run away with Rendrin. We'll pop it and we'll start running. He's a tango and it's just underneath his tower. Just safe. So here in the mid lane, yeah, they're gonna turn it into a bit of a dual lane here as Milan is just gonna be here to annoy Fuhu as well. Not much fun here for him. Instantly forced to pop his salve there to stay alive. And just to be able to stay in the lane. Seems like the Wraith King is just gonna keep his points like it is for now. Denied. See how it all turns out here in the bottom. So far, actually, the Doom has been out CSing the Wraith King, although the Wraith King had some help from Quepe in the beginning. Oh, Spartan, do they really want to go here? They need a two-man crush and they will get it just to have Luft escape. But there is an haste here on the bane and he has a nightmare. Luft is going to be nightmared up. There's going to be the AI's Vortex as well. They want to kill this one, but Luft can't really run anywhere. He's going to get off another crush. They do have a brain step if they need it, but they don't. Spartan with the right clicks with the chilling touch is more than enough to kill him off over there. In the meantime, they're looking for something aggressive here on Excalibur. They're going to walk up to him. He's going to lose all of his refraction charges really, really fast. And there's going to be the hook. Quepe connects and Excalibur is going to die here as Fuhu picks up the kill. Death is the only antidote. How many times has he played? Does he have any hooks? So, well, he has played it more than often, I would say here. Quepe it is. Completely stacked out DC hook for him. A nice Doom was able to get the Satyr here with his unholy aura, so he just has pretty much unlimited HP regeneration there once he has score surge from. Without anything right now, he already has 0.8. It's so much. Should be 4 though. Oh, 6.8, yeah. They want to hook him. Quepe is ready. Is he going to get it off? Yes, he gets Doom. Hello, Doom. What are you going to do now? Pops the Scorcher. He's trying to get out. Heal Bomb is going to connect here. There's going to be Brave Fireblast now. They need to burst him down. He has level 3 Scorcher, but it's not going to be enough. There's enough damage coming out from the side of Sephiroth TV. As a Dazzle will pick it up. Seems like Milan wants to do something on middle here. He gets up the Nightmare. Fuhu is completely blind. Excalibur is going to walk in, but there's going to be the TP in as well from a moment. Is he going to get off the Shadow Grave? No, he's not, as he actually doesn't have it skilled yet. Excalibur will pick up the skill, making it a 6-2 on the scoreboard. Luft is on his own here. He can't really fight up against him with all of these creeps nearby as well. Just wants to get this creep wave away from the neutral camp. So we can safely farm it up, but it's just waiting until Chihaya has this finished and they might just be able to pick up a kill there as well. And there's a problem. Milan doesn't have enough mana to really do everything. Oh, the hook from Quepe is not going to connect this time around. So it's a nice try there. Points for efforts. So far, the Wraith King hasn't been having too good of a time, although they were able to get a kill on the Doom. He is still 4 CS behind. And that's not the place you want to be in. Doom already has his signature move, Doom Up, as well, so... It won't be the easiest of times now for the Wraith King here. He will need help, and at the moment... He's gonna stay there. Oh, they just instantly Doom him up here, but there is a Shadow Grave. Doesn't have the mana now for it anymore. They're gonna try and turn this one around on the Doom. As he's just fighting underneath the tower, although he has Scorcher, he's still taking a lot of damage. And he will get out now. 40 mana regen is ridiculous, but it will end now as they get up a double kill here on top with a rotation in from Kwepe. Hitting his hooks at the moment. Already 3-1-3. So far this push has been doing what it has to be doing. Getting the kills all around the map. Well, that's an early offer wall for the Doom here. Will boost his damage, but I don't think that's the thing he needs in the lane right now. I think he more needs the sustain from an unholy aura. There was nothing really else in the neighborhood to eat, so... The hard camp actually had a satyr, so... Could have gone for that. You know, Kwepe from Heihei United. He was a player for that team. Heihei United is also actually in the tournament. They're playing against London Conspiracy on Friday. I think it's either 21 CET or 20 CET, but I'm not completely sure about the exact time. You have to check the schedule for that. So, Bane has started the stacks here. It's actually already 4 stack here. So that's really nice for the TA. Milan could just take over the mid lane while Excalibur is going in jungle, and after that might just go instantly to this Ancient stack as level 3 Psyblades as well as level 4 Refraction. So should be able to take it pretty easily. Kwepe went for the Tranquils with Soaring build. Milan, is he gonna walk into the range? No, he's not. He's just staying outside of it as well. Still walks forward, and the moment forever is gonna be there. He actually has the poison touch, and it's gonna slow down Bane a lot, and they're just running with Kwepe with the Tranquils on, pick up the kill, Phenomancer get it. They're gonna TP in here. It's gonna be the Doom. As well as Excalibur rotating now as well. There's not gonna be an ultimate coming out from Fohu, as he's just gonna get slapped down. And but there's gonna be the hook from Kwepe. Take him out, they're gonna look for the deny on him soon. They don't really have any other choice. Derek comes out, Kwepe denying the Phenomancer here. Same time, of course, a moment for effort did die underneath the tier 1 in middle here from the side of energy. Excalibur picking it up? No, it was actually Sherba tree. Yeah, still at the moment, they don't really have anything to do against this Doom Wraith King situation. They can't really kill each other, they both need help, and... Popping the reincarnation to kill him, I guess, it should be worth it. Will help you out pretty nicely as well. Also, I'm wondering what the build is gonna be for him. We see a lot of Blink Daggers, Blade Mills, sometimes Midas first as well. But at 9 meters and not having the build up ready yet for that, it pretty much just means that he's not gonna get it. Doom's taking a lot of damage from this. Does have Scorcher, so he should be okay, and just trying to turn this one around, as you can see. Pops the face boot and just running him down. He might just be able to pop the reincarnation here, but no, a moment forever comes in and they're just gonna kill him off in return. Nice rotation in there from Dazzle just in the nick of time. Going there to save his teammate. Same time, they have some plays here for Excalibur to farm up the Ancients. They do know it is from the side of Severe TV, but they're not really able to contest it. You want to say there was a kill on top? Kwepe was, of course, involved in that, as he is pretty much involved in every single kill made by Severe TV. They've been playing really good on the push so far. Already 8 out of the 13 kills. He has been there. Oh, they popped the trap here on fire. They want to kill him. They're going to get out the slow, but he just pops his ultimates, trying to kill off anyone here in return, but I don't think they're able to do it. Unless the hook from Kwepe is going to connect. No, he gets a creep, and that's not what he wants. So it just ends in a kill there on the Venomancer, who had to pop his poison over though. Ooh, Luffy just out of sight of the Ice Blast over there. As a dodge a bit from Chiaia, he doesn't really want to fight up against him when he's under 400 HP. That's not what he wants. They're going to TP into mid, or there's going to be the engagement as they just completely destroy Kwepe here. Although he had the dominating streak, it was still only worth just short on the 400. Although he got a bunch of kills, he hasn't really got a lot of net worth on him. Just 2.7k at the moment. If you compare that to Excalibur with 5.7, it doesn't really feel like a lot. Excalibur's going for the Yashe, not something you see too often. It's more of the older builds, as it's all about getting Desolator first or Blink Dagger first right now. Still, it does give you more damage, more speed. It's just an overall strong item on any agility hero. And there comes the hook. They find Milan, and Milan just gets blown up before he can brain step. So it's an easy kill there for the side of Saphira. There comes out the hook. Oh, just short here. Spartan able to just barely dodge this one. How is Luffy doing on his progress towards the Blink Dagger? Just only 800 gold off, so it's going nice for him. Aya Blast is not going to connect on him again. Doesn't connect on anyone, and Fu is just pretty much just left alone here in the middle. Putting down the wards and slowly but surely chipping away at this tower. Milan has to come in and defend this. Does have a smoke ready if they want to go for to bottom and help out there with Fiend's Grip. Everyone with the Excalibur is going to go for now. Yes, our 400 gold, and with the Yashe finish up, I don't think this is a game where you go Manta first. Although it dispels amplify damage, I don't think it's really worth it. Radiant's top tower has been denied. He should just leave it as a casual one for now. And upgrade later. Defensive Weave comes out as they're looking into getting this tower here in middle. On bottom, I mean, as the meantime, in middle, that's the hook from Quepa getting Milan again. He is just really hating on top of him right now. Already 4 kills on Milan here. He's not having the best of games. Some nice bottle training here. Taking it, giving the regeneration to Quepa so he can just keep on ganking here. They're going to rotate in with Luft as well. They're going to look for some kills here in bottom. Sprint is popped. Who are they going to find? Should be able to see him now. Quepa hook him. Oh, they're just going to completely stun him up here. AA Blast comes out. It's going to hit a moment forever. He's going to go down. They need to destroy this tower. If they really want to keep on fighting here, they will be able to do so. Rave King gets the kill. Luffy goes over after Spartan. First is there. Fish Game comes out on the Rave King, but he doesn't care too much. He doesn't have enough mana, though, for the reincarnation, so it will be the end of him. Just stealing too much of his mana there, not able to pop the reincarnation afterwards. Nice rotation in for Milan. They may get a 3 for 2, but they do take a tower for Saphira. So a little bit in favor for Saphira TV, but not too much. If they lose this tower, it's in complete favor of NLG getting the kill as well as... oh, what? Milan, it was a little bit of no man's land here. He's able to get up the brain step, keep himself alive for now. He needs some help from his teammates. Is this gonna be able to help him out? Quepa, he hooked in so much. Chihaya, he is found. He's trying to win run, but it doesn't matter. Already used in the beginning, he will die. As now Luft goes after Milan, he just needs one more hit. But there's gonna be the race up as well as the melt. Oh, the shield proc keeping Luft alive over there. This was getting really, really close, but in the end, NLG just losing one, not able to turn anything around. Blink Dagger is now down on Slaughter. Might be looking for something there. Excalibur as well has 2k gold. We'll see if he goes for the Manta Cell now. Maybe goes back for a Blink or a Desolator. The Doom, he seems to be going just for the drum builds here. Pretty basic item, just more HP, more mana. As the Doom, you're pretty low mana, so that helps you out really a lot with that. As well, it's just an overall nice item to have. Gives your team some nice auras as well, and having with the Doom going for aura stacks just to help out Excalibur as well. Chihaya will do so much for the team. Venomance has finally been able to complete up the Midas there. It's the Shackle, and Luffy is just going to keep him out. Hitting him with a power shot just to show him who's boss in the end. Dire's middle tower is under attack. They're smoking up here on the side of NLG. They want to look for some pickoff. What are they going to find? Maybe they find Luft. If they can stop him from blinking, they can maybe kill him off. You need to walk up. Dude, I see him right now. They see Loop, but Loop is too fast. He blinks up the hill. This might not be the best place to be. Oh, Spartan pops down a ward. They know where he is, but Crappy can just get him down from the hill. Oh, Fiend Script, they tried to cast it, but it's not gonna hit Luft. He's able to actually blink away from this Ice Blast. There is still the Wraith King Ultimate Reincarnation is ready, and Milan just gets blown up. They get up the trap, so they should be able to just escape from here without any further casualties on the side of energy. Yes, they will just convert it here into a tier 1 push. Here at the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament for Save the Children, guys. I just want to remind everybody that. We have the links up in the panel. Go there. You can also go to donate. You will get sent to our stream. Steam trip. Steam trip. What the hell is wrong with me? Forgetting words. What's wrong with me? Stream tip. And you can donate there through PayPal. 75% of the donations go to the charity as 25% goes to the winning team of our tournament here. As they're able to at least TP out for now. Ooh. They need a Nightmare over Fiend Script and they will get off the Fiend Script. Are they able to burn through all of the mana in time? They're just going to wait for a bit. You need 160. Oh, he's going to be able to at least pop Reincarnation. But they're going to kill. Are able to just kill him off twice here. As he's not able to turn into one. It may be a one for one trade. There's going to be a lot of minutes down there as he's not able to get level 11. He's just so close to it. That's a big blow there for the Wraith King. Ablast flying through, just annoying Luft there. So there's no follow-up. Wofao go for a fill this game. Would bump up the damage coming out from his Poison Nova. Might be nice to pick it up. Crepe already has almost his Blink Dagger if he wants to go for it. He can also opt to go for a... For 4-step, of course, has a ring of health already, so it's gonna be a possible item there for him. Helps out his team as well. 4-step, just one of your teammates forwards. 4-step and back is a lot of utility in it. They're gonna look for a kill here. They wanna get Chihaya, but Chihaya sees the rotation in. It's actually gonna get a kill here. Doom has been put on the Venomancer, and they get a kill with it as well. Gonna put him to the grave for another 40 seconds. I'm gonna turn this one into a tier 1 push right now. It seems like just okay, we're backing off. Top when will Severity if he actually smoke up and to take Roshan? That's the question. You have a really strong Roshan lineup with the minus armor coming out. Same goes for NLG though. Especially with the Desolator now Radiance completed on Excalibur. They're able to take it pretty fast. Oh, Luf walked in to take a look at how it's going, but he does get fringe scripted up. Oh, the power shot miss! But they still have enough damage to kill him off in the end. Slaughter is down it. With that day, it's the signal for NLG to go into the pit. Oh no! Who comes out? Pulling Chihaya away. Not really able to turn this one around. Does have a regeneration rune. So might be able to pop that. But with Excalibur here, they're doing a lot of damage to Roshan. And they're going to be able to take it. Weave comes out. It's going to hit on 3, but there comes the Poison Nova as well. Wave King getting low, but he pops his... Blade Mill to make sure that he can't get popped in the beginning. He needs to look out and TP out here as Excalibur pops his BKB. Oh, his Aegis, I mean, he's not able to kill the Wraith King here, but he's still in the middle of two heroes, but they don't have the damage for now to kill him off. The wards are not going to do enough either as they're going to pick up the kill here on Fuhu. 4 for 2 trade, they did get the Aegis. So essentially 4 for 3 trade in favor of NLG, not able to do anything with the Aegis though. As it's going to be immediately popped. Let's just take a quick look at the crafts here. Oh my god, it's already over 3k in favor of NLG, and it's going to hit the 10k mark. An experience for them. Yes, they've just been able to just split up the map a lot more effectively. Oh, Shackle comes out. But actually didn't last, that surprises me a bit. This is gonna be okay. Push out the offensive weave here, but the tower. Oh, force it forward on Excalibur. They wanna kill him off, but that's not gonna work right now. As they just kill off the Dazzle, a moment is down. Equepe is down as well. They lose too. As the tower now also goes down, so an overall big win here from NLG. just showing what they're made of right now. They're still behind in kills, but they are far ahead in gold as well as experience. Agnims is completed on TI and most likely be looking at either his blink or his crystal is next. Well, Milan, he's a little bit scraping the bottom of the barrel right now. But there you go, they want to go for the Venomancer here. And oh, the AFLS is not going to connect, but they have more than enough damage with Rain Step coming in from Milan. Doom will pick up the kill. They even have some nice wards to farm up here. Slard has to stay in the back here, can't really walk forward. Yeah, they're gonna should be able to take up this tower. I don't think they can really defend it for the side of Severe TV, even if they get a hook out. They would just be initiated upon and just Doom does a blind blink up and he's gonna find him. Oh, Maelstrike is gonna connect to Quepit. Any more damage? There comes out the Christian too, making sure that the Fiend's Grab gets cancelled instantly and Quepit will be able to survive because of it. Reef comes out and will start taking away at the armor of NLG. Should be a signal for them to just turn back. Retreat, take this as a victory. You took a tower, you did some damage. Just get out. Luftus is going for the 4-staff as Quepe already has his completed. Showed it off a couple of times already as well. A moment forever. Walking on threats and some wards and a magic wand, so pretty basic for him. He's the lowest at the moment. Oh, Quepe. Quepe 4-staff himself. 4-dagger hits the Brave Fire Blast. And they're disconnected with the hook and a dismember. Getting another kill on Pudgy. Already 14 stacks up on him. Quepe having a great game. Stacks wise is gonna make him really tanky. As well as magic resist, just bumping it up all the time. No, I'm actually Dutch. To answer your question, I wanna be the Yoshi. I wanna ride the Yoshi, I don't wanna be the Yoshi. Anyhow, back into the game. At the moment, let's just take a quick look at the graphs. It has been plateauing a bit here, still in favor of NLG. Somewhere between 7.5, yeah, it's about 8.5k at the moment as experience took a big dip downwards, but has been going a bit more in favor of Sophia right now, but still it's not where they want it to be. Still well over the 10k mark. Yeah, Blast is coming out, but the side of Sophia have already returned. Wind Ranger 2.2k gold. We're gonna see what's gonna pick him now. He can either buy up a completed Blink Dagger now. Oh, he sees a moment. He's gonna go for the Blink Dagger. Wind Run after a moment. He can't TP out anymore. He's gonna be found. He's gonna die here as well. Check it up and focus fire down. What? Oh, Milan, he's not in the good jungle here. He's gonna get found. He doesn't have a way out. Luffy's just running around this tree. He's gonna find him now. Puts up the amplified damage with the crush and getting the kill here. Volumir is offering together with the Blink Dagger is up on Doom. Giving some nice arrows to Steam, more armor, more damage, more lifesteal. And some more HP regen, of course, and mana regen, but heh, who the hell cares about that? That's not what it's about, that's no fun. Oh, Dooms comes out. Oh, they found Quepe here in the backlines, but they're not really able to follow this up as they go forward with Chihaya. He wants to kill Luft here, but Luft is able to actually blink out for now. Doom is gonna end off, and in the end, no kills taken by any of the sides. As it seems that NLG wasn't really able to find their initiation angle. They spot out this rotation, they see it. And a moment, they have a sentry, they're gonna stop it off now. Some fishing goes down here for the side of NLG. How much do they actually have up? They only have this aggressive ward out here. Apart from that, it's all relying on the TA traps. For the side of Sephiroth, they have one in mid. They have one on the Roshan pit and they have one on the pillar. To check out rotations in here as well. Let's keep an eye on this ancient stack. So, all the fish are coming out for Sephiroth. A little bit less for NLG, but they have more vision around the map globally set. With all the traps out, they don't have any in the Roshan pit though, but it's not going to be up for another 2 minutes. Oh, Rave King is going to Radiance build this game. taking down these refraction charges, as well as just applying this global mischance whenever someone is close, is gonna be nice. It's still 17%, but still, it can make a difference in a fight between surviving and dying. So they're gonna get a nice rotation in here. On Milan, he is gonna be caught out, he's gonna be killed as well. Four steps and blinks used on the side of Saphira to get this one. Nicely coordinated there. How many stacks is Squepe? That's of course the question. 15 stacks up on him already. This guy's going crazy with stacks. Let's see what's Doom going for. 1.2k. He's pretty much invested everything so far in like mid-game oriented items only. The also initiation of course, but apart from the flats, like, it's all just filling up with cheap items. He might be going for Shiva's next to go together with his blink, or maybe up to, yeah, he needs to Shiva's if, because going refresher right now is not really something he can do, just due to the fact he won't have enough mana to cast the double doom. But I know where Doom is. Oh, the hook from Quepe just falling short there. Straight up pings from NLG, saying they're there. Yeah, just try for this tower, focus firing it down. There's no glyph either for the side of NLG, of Saphira. They do have Rave King with a... they do have the Rave King with the Radiance now. Let's see, what is Excalibur back to answer on that? Desolator, Montastel, as expected, another 3k gold as well. Oh, the Doom comes out, on who does he put it? He puts on the Phenomancer, nice target there. But they're not really able to follow it up right now, as the team was too far in the back. They want to defend this tower for Sphere defeat. Actually, Naganim's here on Phenomancer, just giving him some more stats as well. Who comes out? And Milan. He's just not having his day on that one. And there comes out the AA Blast. Is going to connect on three here. They want to focus them down. Luftus run away. Will it be popped? Ah, he's going to be popped here. No, actually not. The Shadow Wave from a moment is just going to keep him alive. Well, the chase is on here for Sphere defeat. Chiaia is looking behind them. He wants to reinitiate from the back, maybe. Shaka comes out, keeping a moment there. Luft getting close, but there's going to be the blink from Chiaia. Birdrun as well. They're not going to catch him now. They will be able to know where he is, so he might just have to retreat all the way back to base. Yeah, the Illusion Stone, Illusion Room won't help you with that. I'm sorry. Yeah, just to comment on the Rave King name, it's just like that due to the fact it's not on the on the ticket. So I'm sorry for that. Just don't pay it any attention. As I just call him Rave King. Try to not focus too much on him as well. That's it. BKB is going to be the item for Excalibur this game. Milan's walking aggressively forward. Maybe Quepe is able to get off an hook here. They do have Doom up. Actually, all the ultimate friend as well as Saphira are up. They don't have a lot of mana at the moment on the Dazzle, so that might be a bit troublesome. So Excalibur, let's see what he can do with these items so far. At the moment he's 10-1-2-4, so he's been having an awesome game. Roshan is up, I need to mention that they did try to take it, but both sides are very wary of the fact that's up. Look at these traps though. Once the smoke pops, they know exactly where pretty much everybody from the side of Saphira is. Yeah. Both sides really just have excellent vision with wards. Oh, Chihaya, he's gonna be hooked straight into the crush. There comes out the AA Blast, but it's not gonna be enough. Chihaya needs to run away, but he's not gonna be able to do so. Let's focus him down and we'll kill him off. Same time, Rave King is gonna be able to kill off the AA. Excalibur comes in, picks up a kill on the A moment here. Now they wanna go for Rave King, but he has reincarnation, so even if they pop him once, he's just gonna come back as the ultimate comes out. From forward, the Quepe hookshot is gonna miss. Seems like NLG just wants to return at the same time Saphira want to go for more Luft. He needs to find Milan here. He's trying to juke and jive, but the damage from Poison Nova as well as the Rage is just too much. The Slaughter will just pick it up with a crush in the end. And with this Saphira TV, pick up 3 kills and just go for Roshanna. Having the Slaughter here, it should be pretty easy going. Oh, Kwepe found someone. But actually, did he found someone? Or was he found? He gets killed by Excalibur together with the Doom. Oh, Doom though. He might have just bit off a bit more than he can chew. We'll back off for now. AA Blast comes out. It's gonna hit on the Slaughter. Slaughter goes down. Level Dead is gonna kill off Fuhu now as well. Excalibur needs to run out. He's a little bit of a no man's land. As this team's actually retreat around, it's gonna be a moment who has the Shadow Grave himself as the Excalibur gets off. The Maelstrike Kwepe comes in, gets the godlike spree away from Excalibur. Nice hookshot coming out from him. Shackled. Red King, he needs to get out and need to hook him. Now they will just force have him for now. They have a hook ready as well if needed. And Kwepe might just have to use it. And oh, it does not connect, meaning that he will die here. They tried it, but it didn't work out. During this time, Roshan is still up. Excalibur is maybe miss blink here. I don't think that's the place he wants to be. And Ice Blast is gonna snipe out a moment forever. 408 gold going the way of Spartan. And another hookshot. They find the Doom, dismember him up, and they kill him off as well, as he wasn't able to put out his Doom. The Scatterer, in the meantime, has been able to kill Roshan. They shackle up Fuhu, but they have the hookshot as well as the Force Staff to save him, but he's still gonna be focused fired. They need a bit more damage. They just. Just run him down, run 4 steps, it's enough. They don't care about towers. 4 steps coming, oh. TP coming in from Luf, going for the Blink Aggressive, is gonna find the AA. But now it's gonna be Fiend's Grip up, and with the Maelstrike there from Excalibur, they kill him off. Kwepe, he has to run away for now. But now he goes forward, he knows that the backup is there. Excalibur pops a Manta just after he got hooked, he's just trying to kill Kwepe here, but there comes out the Shallow Grave. He gets dismembered while BKB is popped, and they need a bit more damage for to kill Excalibur here. We'll be able to do so for now, as Kwepe will be dead here. As now Bane needs to do something. He doesn't have anything to protect himself, as he's stuck between the Wraith King as well as the Creep. He does have a reincarnation, so Excalibur will just go away. Leave it for what it is. As we're gonna see a late Blink Dagger coming out for Wraith King, opting to go back for that. Just want some more mobility here to catch out the Heroes of Energy as well as not to be kited around as heavily as he was before. So look at his net, his experience per minute. Really, Excalibur is just going crazy this game. 1.8k, almost 1.9k. Just need 600 gold for that. Already has 2.4k up. We'll see if he's gonna go for either a Daedalus or an MKB this game. Might go for an MKB, yes, there is a Radiance up. We'll, you know, further his DPS by more. But a Doom. But up a Plate Mail here is either going to be a Shivas or AC. I'm going to suspect it's going to be a Shivas. As now, Venomancer is going to be found. He pops out his Poison Nova, but he won't be able to pick up any kills with it. Luft is trying to rotate in here, but just him alone is not going to be enough. Kwepe also TP's into tier 2, but really, are they going to find anything? Oh, as they go forward, but Luft, and they followed up with the hookshot as well. Excalibur is just able to pop the BKB and turn his run around. Luft taking a lot of damage, is doomed up as well. He gets killed. Excalibur goes forward. Kwepe is able to just force staff out. I think they saw Dazzle. They just popped down a ward for now. Nice ward, should give them a lot of vision here. Yeah, they know where everybody is. This blast is gonna go over Kwepe. It hit him, they wanna kill him off in time here before he gets back, and Excalibur will do so. Gets the kill, and now reincarnation is pop Excalibur. He needs to pop his refreshing charges. No, he doesn't. There's just gonna be the Fiend Script as Milan walks in from the back. They pick up 4 kills here on the top lane in the end. NLG looking strong, taking out the tier 2 as well. They seem able to want to end this game, or at least get a lane of Rex here as they walk up to the high ground. Nothing really on the side for Saphira to stop it. They do have a Poison Nova, but there's no follow-up, even if he goes in. Which means he has to walk in, because he doesn't have a Blink Dagger of sorts. Maybe if he... Ooh, this is just barely off the mark. They're going to be able to get back. It's actually going to be an AC. They're like, okay, we're going to be pushing into high ground, so we'll just build that item. As the tier 3 now has also been destroyed. Actually, already before, maybe right now. I don't know. I think it was already destroyed. They're going to take the Rex as well. Two lanes of Rex now down. For the site of Zephyr TV and NLG are actually able to get away for now. Scorch Free. Oh, Luft, Luft. No, 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 no. Get out. Stay back. He still wants to go forward. He has to force stuff out instantly. Shekko is not going to latch, so he's going to be fine. Is Sparta TPing out of the vision? Yes, he is, but he's not going to be punished for it. Beefs are now completed here on Spartan, as it seems that he's not going for the Agonips build here. He's just going for, well, the Griefs in the end. Just wants out just to help out his team more with the pushes. As well as the armor is just nice to nullify some of the minus armor from the amplified damage, of course. Seems like NLG are okay. They took a big victory. So they were able to take two lanes of Rex. Tier 2 and middle is still up, so it seems like they're just going to wait for Roshan. We'll see the timer in about 3 minutes and 10 to 20 seconds. Oh, Excalibur! He sees a moment. A moment might just die here. He has to TP out and we'll be able to do so. No, it can be Prox. Oh, the AWS is going to be short and too late. Did right? Luft? Luft? What? Oh, they see him with the ward! He has to use his crush, but he's not... Oh, just a force up. Just able to beautifully dodge in the end. The power shield there. As Doom is trying to walk in and go for the Rave King. Rave King has to run out. They just want to follow him. Level Death comes out. And Nightmare and then follow-up hookshot coming out. But they find Fuhu now. If they want, if they're actually able to kill him off, there will be a big chunk of the team fight of Zephyra down. They're looking for more. Luft has... yeah, he had to blink in 2 seconds, but they will need to pop Shadow Grave to help him. But that will leave a moment... Well, low on his skills because he really needed a Shadow Grave to save himself there from Excalibur. And now the tier 2 push is gonna commit. Once they get 2 kills, they're just gonna try for the high ground. They have everybody here in middle. They are missing 2 ultimates. Finch Crip and the ALS. ALS will be coming up soon enough. Oh, Excalibur able to nicely dodge or pop the Mantastel there, just creating some confusion on who's the real one. Excalibur, he actually gets 4-step into the range of the fountain. He's getting low and... He just barely survived with 100 HP. There comes out the Griefs to heal him up some furthermore. Yes. Oh, what? Oh, Doom is going in aggressive. He will pay with his life for this one. There we go. He's dead. Airblast comes out. Not gonna find Luf, but they will call GG here on the side of Zephyr TV. NLG have been able to take game 1 in his best of 3 here. In the Rangers bracket quarterfinal. At the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament for Save the Children. Yeah, Eddie Kwepa was playing a bit like a dandy. His hook shots were phenomenal. This game is absolutely not for him. Was not a Kwepa this loss, but still in the end, they did lose as a team here to No Logic Gaming. They will be having a chance again in the second game here. As we'll just go into the break, guys, make sure to go to streamtip.com/t/SwissDC_EN to donate. We'll show all the donations up on our stream. With all of that said, see you guys soon for the second game.